And welcome back to Mass Effect. Blind. It doesn't show up in the quest log, but I'm pretty sure we have to go meet with the council again. Citadel Tower. Other than that, I realize now we met with that guy Conrad Werner. I'm not sure why it's still showing up in quest log. But there it is. So we have really nothing to do except to go to two other completely different planets, scan more keepers. I'm only missing four of them. And yeah, that's Werner. Where? Up here. I think this goes a little bit faster. Shifts your point of view, which is interesting. I always wonder about the well-dressed man sitting there. What's he doing? Got that one right.
Come on. Udina's presenting the Quarian's evidence to the council.
Oh, goody.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
Right.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof? There it is.
That's right.
This evidence is irrefutable, Ambassador. Saren will be stripped of his Spectre status, and all efforts will be made to bring him in to answer for his crimes.
I recognize the other voice, the one speaking with Saren. Matriarch Benezia.
Matriarch Benezia?
Who is she?
Matriarchs are powerful Asari who have entered the final stage of their lives.
Oh, she's an Asari.
Revered for their wisdom and experience. They serve as guides and mentors to my people. Matriarch Benezia is a powerful biotic, and she had many followers. She will make a formidable ally for Saren.
I'm more interested in the Reapers. What do you know about them?
Only what was extracted from the Geth's memory core. The Reapers were an ancient race of machines that wiped out the Protheans. Then they vanished.
God, her nose. So... wiped out the Protheans and vanished. Saren's bringing them back.
The Geth believe the Reapers are gods, and Saren is the prophet for their return.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
It's trouble.
Saren thinks it can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy? Impossible. It has to be. Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found no trace of their existence? If they were real, we'd have found something.
A lot of questions there. The Reapers are real.
I tried to warn you about Saren and you refused to face the truth. Don't make the same mistake again.
This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know.
I love his robe.
The Reapers are obviously just a myth, Commander. A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend he is using to bend the Geth to his will.
Come on. You're wrong.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
That is not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your fleet in!
A fleet cannot track down one man.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
Or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
So you'll do nothing?
Every time humanity asks for help, you ignore us.
Shepard's right. I'm sick of this council and its anti-human bull.
Ambassador. There is another solution.
Wow.
A way to stop Saren that does not require fleets or armies.
No, it's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
Oh, yeah. It's the best solution.
You don't have to send a fleet into the Traverse, and the Ambassador gets his human Spectre. Everybody's happy.
That look. Cast your votes.
Commander Shepard, step forward.
Hell yeah. That nod. Main theme.
It is the decision of the Council that you be granted all the powers and privileges of the Special Tactics and Reconnaissance Branch of the Citadel.
Spectres are not trained, but chosen. Individuals forged in the fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal, a symbol, the embodiment of courage, determination, and self-reliance. They are the right hand of the Council, instruments of our will.
Spectres bear a great burden. They are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense. The safety of the galaxy is theirs to uphold.
You are the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
Thank you.
I'm honored, Counselor.
We're sending you into the Traverse after Saren. He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
Any leads?
Any idea where to find him?
We will forward any relevant files to Ambassador Udina.
This meeting of the Council is adjourned.
I'm the Spectre. Why don't you forward it to me?
Congratulations, Commander.
We've got a lot of work to do, Shepard. You're going to need a ship, a crew, supplies.
You'll get access to special equipment and training now.
Cool.
You should go down to the CSEC Academy and speak to the Spectre Requisitions Officer.
Anderson, come with me. I'll need your help to set all this up.
That's awesome.
Bastard didn't even thank you.
Yeah, it's no big deal.
He's got a lot on his mind. Come on.
Right behind you, Shepard.
Spectre training, charm, and intimidate talents unlocked. Cool. Just want to check something. Okay, I found it. This is where we can level up. So I'm already at level 9. I have 23 points. Carnage. Well, he doesn't have any points. Neither does she. Okay. Marksman. Increases damage and accuracy, reduces chance of overheating. Charm and intimidate. Okay, that's gonna have to do with the conversation options, I'm sure. Spectre training. So I can't use, I can't level up shotguns, even though I can use shotguns and pistols. I guess I'm specialized in pistols. I'm sure you guys will have some insight. Oh, unlock, never mind. Unlock shotguns here. So I haven't even been able to use shotguns at all. So now I have shotguns. Carnage. Fire blast of particles inflicting weapon damage plus 50% to any enemy within 2 meters of its impact point. We're starting to run out of points though. Store discount. Motivated buyer. Barrier. Ooh. Yeah. Unlock Z-Warp. Barrier unlocked. Bolsters your shield with a biotic barrier that will absorb up to 400 points of damage. Will not block attacks that bypass shields. Okay, I have 11. Unlock lift here. Assault training. Oh yeah. So much. Resets the cooldown. Okay, what else? ...2% discount isn't much. I mean, when we're buying more expensive things, it's gonna make more of a difference. So I'm gonna wait on that, because we don't have that much money anyway to be buying stuff. Carnage throw. Restores dead squad members with 15% health and 40% shields. Yeah. Now we're supposed to report for Spectre training, so I think I'm going to hold on to these points for now. Leveled. Sec. For some reason, I love this little background song here. Well, it's not showing up, but I think we're supposed to go to requisition office. Oh no. Alliance docking bay.
How can you fight your own people, Rex? There aren't that many of you left.
Anyone who fights us is either stupid or on Saren's payroll. Killing the latter is business. Killing the former is a favor to the universe.
Hmm. Doop doop. So yeah, I see the little dot or exclamation mark here. Ah, here we go.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
Woohoo!
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
What's going on?
I want the truth. Why are you stepping down, sir?
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
There's more to this.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
You wear this for me, psycho. Option. What went wrong?
What happened?
I failed. I couldn't make the cut. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me.
Oh, sheesh.
I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
Saren will pay.
Saren's not gonna get away this time.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the conduit is before he does.
What about the Reapers?
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one, Shepard. I'm not sure they even exist.
But if they do exist, the conduit's the key to bringing them back. Stop Saren from getting the conduit, and we stop the Reapers from returning.
Is that it?
Anything else?
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording. She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tau cluster.
Liara, yeah, the Asari, the blue-skinned one. I've heard about her. I haven't heard anything about her, just that, she's in the game and seems to have a few fans. I will start there then.
Sounds like we should head for the Artemis Tau cluster.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
Yeah, tell Adina that.
Your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
Yeah, well, that's your job.
I'll take care of Saren. You take care of the political fallout.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre.
I'm still a human.
I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
Yeah, I don't like that guy. Screw him. We got Renegade plus two. I just saw that. Go to Novaria. Investigate reports of Geth on the world. Pharos, see what colony was attacked by Geth. Find Liara. Explore the uncharted world of the Artemis Tau cluster. To find her.
Yes, Commander?
What can you tell me about Pharos?
Any extra intel you can give me on our colony at Pharos?
The entire planet used to be one giant Prothean city. Mostly ruins now. But some of the infrastructure is still intact. The colony tried to build on what the Protheans left behind. We lost all contact with them when the Geth attacked.
And what about Novaria?
What can you tell me about Novaria?
Novaria's trouble. Always has been. The whole planet's basically a center for corporations to conduct illegal research. Watch your back, though. Spectres are about the only form of Citadel authority Novaria respects. But they aren't popular.
What can you tell me about the Artemis Tau cluster?
What do you know about the Artemis Tau cluster?
Not much. I've never been there myself. A handful of systems with a few small, uncharted worlds, but no real colonies. Might not be easy finding Dr. Tassoni out there. My advice is to look for the world with the Prothean ruins.
Huh. Well, we're gonna have to find her eventually, right? So why would we head somewhere else first? Think she might be easier to find later? You okay?
How are you holding up?
Honestly, this isn't how I pictured my career coming to an end. Pushing papers really isn't my thing, but you're the one who can stop Saren. I believe in you, Shepard. If that means I have to step aside, so be it.
I didn't know that you and Saren had a past.
Tell me what happened with you and Saren 20 years ago.
It's close to 20 years ago now. Ambassador Goyle was our representative here on the Citadel. Like Udina, she wanted to get a human into the Spectres. She chose me. The Council sent Saren to keep an eye on me and evaluate my performance, just like they sent Nihilus to keep tabs on you.
I don't know why she'd be so mad about it. I mean, it's his business. What happened?
I think I deserve the whole story.
We had intel on a rogue scientist being funded by Batarian interests. He was trying to set up a facility to develop illegal AI technology out in the Verge. Alliance intel had done all the work, but the Council wanted a Spectre involved. We compromised. I was assigned to help Saren in his investigation. We tracked the scientist to a refining facility on Kamala. He was hidden away somewhere inside, protected by an army of Batarian mercenaries. The plan was simple. Sneak into the plant, capture the scientist, sneak back out. Quick, quiet, and a minimum of bloodshed.
Something went wrong?
I'm guessing things didn't go as planned.
Saren and I split up to cover more ground. Then about halfway through the mission, there was a massive explosion in the refinery core. Officially, it was ruled an accident, but I think Saren detonated it on purpose to draw off the enemy guards.
Was anyone hurt?
How many casualties?
The explosion tore the refinery to shreds. The whole place was on fire. Black chemical clouds poured out into the atmosphere. Nobody inside survived.
Damn.
There was a camp for the workers and their families nearby. Between the fires and the toxic fumes, the final death count was over 500. Mostly civilians. Saren didn't care. The target was eliminated. Mission accomplished. And I ended up taking the blame. That ended all talk of me joining the Spectres.
You got blamed for it, huh?
Saren caused the explosion. How'd he pin it on you?
In his report, Saren accused me of blowing his cover. He said it was my fault the guards were ready for us. He claimed that's why it turned into a massacre. Saren's report was all the proof the Council needed to kill my chances of becoming a Spectre.
It's not fair.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Who do you think the Council was going to listen to? Me? Or their best agent? I had a bad feeling about him right from the start. I should have been more careful. Maybe I could have stopped things before they got out of hand.
Well, obviously it wasn't your fault.
Don't blame yourself, Captain.
I don't. I blame Saren. I think he wanted things to go bad. He was looking for an excuse to blow that refinery. Maybe he just likes the violence. Maybe he was just trying to make me look bad to keep humans out of the Spectres. If so, he pulled it off.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
What?
Who do you think the Council was going to listen to? I had a bad feeling about him right from the start. I should have been more careful. Maybe I could have stopped things before they got out of hand.
I don't have any other choice. It's just going to go between it wasn't your fault and that's not fair. I eventually going to have to tell him forget about the past. That's stupid that that's kind of, you know, forced into that.
The only thing I care about is stopping Saren.
You're right, Commander. It's no good living.
I should go.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Codex.
In the early 2160s, the Alliance began aggressive colonization of worlds in the Skillian Verge, much to the dismay of the Batarians, who had been developing the region for several decades. In 2171, the Batarians petitioned the Council to declare the Verge a zone of Batarian interest. The Council refused, however, declaring unsettled worlds in the region open to human colonization. In protest, the Batarians closed their Citadel embassy and severed official diplomatic relations with the Council, effectively becoming a rogue state. They instigated a proxy war in the Verge by funneling money and weapons to criminal organizations, urging them to strike at human colonies. Hostilities peaked with the Skillian Blitz of 2176, an attack on the human capital of Elysium by Batarian-funded pirates and slavers. In 2178, the Alliance retaliated with a crushing assault on the moon of Torfin, long used as a staging base by Batarian-backed criminals. In the aftermath, the Batarians retreated into their own systems and are now rarely seen in Citadel space.
So these are these Batarians we hear about once in a while.
Pharos is a habitable world in the Attican Beta Cluster. Two-thirds of the habitable surface is covered with the ruins of a crumbling Prothean megatropolis. In the millennia since the Prothean extinction, the ruins have been repeatedly picked over by looters many times. Pharos was considered a poor prospect for colonization, as little open ground remains for agriculture. The only sizable freshwater sources are the poles, which are tapped by the decaying Prothean aqueduct systems. The dead cities, while in good condition considering their antiquity, are of uncertain stability. Ground level is congested by a dozen meters of fallen debris, and the air is fouled by dust. In 2178, the Human Exogeny Corporation announced its intention to place a permanent colony on Pharos to thoroughly explore the ruins. The pioneer settlement was placed on the upper levels of several intact skyscrapers, using the surviving Prothean aqueducts and rooftop hydroponic gardens to support the population.
You know, I know I looked at these, but now that we've asked about them, I'm wondering if they've put some more information. I mean, I obviously can't remember every single thing they said, so...
Novaria is a cool, rocky world with most of its hydrosphere locked up in massive glaciers. A privately chartered colony world, the planet is owned by the Novaria Development Corporation Holding Company. The NDC is funded by investment capital from two dozen high-technology development firms and administrated by an executive board representing their interests. The investors built remote hot labs in isolated locations across Novaria's surface. These facilities are used for research too dangerous or controversial to be performed elsewhere, as Novaria is technically not part of Citadel space and therefore exempt from Council law. By special arrangement, Citadel special tactics and reconnaissance agents have been granted extraterritorial privileges, but it remains to be seen how committed the executive board is to that principle. Given its unique situation, it is understandable that Novaria is often implicated in all manner of wild conspiracy theories.
Okay, I'm pretty sure this is new, though.
There are between 200 and 400 billion stars in the galaxy, and less than 1% of them have ever been visited or had their systems properly surveyed. Humanity's early expansion into the Attican Traverse was haphazard. A desperate race to claim habitable planets where populations can be economically settled. Ignored in the wake of this land grab were thousands of less hospitable worlds, each potentially rich with industrial resources. The wealth of entire solar systems lies untapped, waiting for corporate survey teams or independent pioneers to discover and exploit them. However, this is not an easy task. In addition to the environmental hazards, the fact that uncharted worlds are largely ignored makes them popular bases for criminals, revolutionaries, cults, and others who wish to remain unnoticed by galactic society.
Interesting. So who knows what the hell we'll find out there. Technology, oh, and weapons.
Biotics is the ability of rare individuals to manipulate... An artificial intelligence is a self-aware computing system capable of learning and independent decision-making. Creation of a conscious AI requires adaptive code, a slow, expensive education, and a specialized quantum computer called a blue box. An AI cannot be transmitted across a communication channel or computer network. Without its blue box, an AI is no more than data files. Loading these files into a new blue box will create a new personality, as variations in the quantum hardware and runtime results create unpredictable variations. The Geth serve as a cautionary tale against the dangers of rogue AI, and in Citadel space, they are technically illegal. Advocacy groups argue, however, that an AI is a living, conscious entity, deserving the same rights as organics. They argue that continued use of the term artificial is institutionalized racism on the part of organic life. The term synthetic is considered the politically correct alternative.
Oh, brother. Virtual intelligence.
A virtual intelligence is an advanced form of user interface software. VIs use a variety of methods to simulate natural conversation, including an audio interface and an avatar personality to interact with. Although a VI can provide a convincing emulation of sentience, they are not self-aware, nor can they learn or take independent action. VIs are used as operating systems on commercial and home computers. Minimal VI agents are also available. Agents are compact and specialized. Some serve as personal secretaries, filtering calls and scheduling meetings based on user-defined priorities. Others are advanced search engines, propagating themselves across the extranet to collate user-requested data. Commercial VIs in a variety of stock personalities are available at any software retailer. Boutique firms and hobbyists also build unique VIs to personal specification. Although software emulation of living personalities is illegal, reconstructions of famous historical figures are common.
Interesting. So we might run across a VI of Abraham Lincoln or something. Now, mass effect fields and relays are new here?
Element zero can increase or decrease the mass of a volume of space-time when subjected to an electrical current. With a positive current, mass is increased. With a negative current, mass is decreased. The stronger the current, the greater the magnitude of the dark energy mass effect. In space, low-mass fields allow FTL travel and inexpensive surface-to-orbit transit. High-mass fields create artificial gravity and push space debris away from vessels. In manufacturing, low-mass fields permit the creation of evenly blended alloys, while high-mass compaction creates dense, sturdy construction materials. The military makes extensive use of mobility-enhancing technologies, with Mass Effect utilizing fighting vehicles standard frontline issue in most military forces. Mass Effect fields are also essential in the creation of kinetic barriers or shields to protect against enemy fire.
And mass relays themselves?
Mass relays are feats of Prothean engineering advanced far beyond the technology of any living species. They are enormous structures scattered throughout the stars and can create corridors of virtually mass-free space, allowing instantaneous transit between locations separated by years or even centuries of travel using conventional FTL drives. Primary mass relays can propel ships thousands of light years, often from one spiral arm of the galaxy to another. However, they have fixed one-to-one connections. A primary relay connects to one other primary relay and nowhere else. Secondary relays can only propel ships across a few hundred light years. However, they are omnidirectional. A secondary relay can send a ship to any other relay within its limited range. There are many dormant primary relays whose corresponding twins have not yet been located. These are left inactive until their partner is charted, as established civilizations are unwilling to blindly open a passage that might connect them to a hostile species.
Yeah, you never know where you're gonna end up. Weapons, armor, and equipment.
Combat hard suits use... All modern infantry weapons, from pistols to assault rifles, use micro-scaled mass accelerator technology. Projectiles consist of tiny metal slugs suspended within a mass-reducing field, accelerated by magnetic force to speeds that inflict kinetic damage. The ammo magazine is a simple block of metal, The gun's internal computer calculates the mass needed to reach the target based on distance, gravity, and atmospheric pressure, then shears off an appropriate-sized slug from the block. A single block can supply thousands of rounds, making ammo a non-issue during any engagement. Top-line weapons also feature smart targeting that allows them to correct for weather and environment. Firing on a target in a howling gale feels the same as it does on a calm day at the practice range. Smart targeting does not mean a bullet will automatically find the mark every time the trigger is pulled. It only makes it easier for the marksman to aim.
Interesting. Okay. Normandy weapons? Codex.
Combat hard suits use a dual layer. A mass accelerator propels a solid metal slug using precisely controlled electromagnetic attraction and repulsion. The slug is designed to squash or shatter on impact, increasing the energy it transfers to the target. If this were not the case, it would simply punch a hole right through, doing minimal damage. Accelerator design was revolutionized by Element Zero. A slug lightened by a mass effect field can be accelerated to greater speeds, permitting projectile velocities that were previously unattainable. If accelerated to a high enough velocity, a simple paint chip can impact with the same destructive force as a nuclear weapon.
Damn.
However, mass accelerators produce recoil equal to their impact energy. This is mitigated somewhat by the mass effect fields that rounds are suspended within. But weapon recoil is still the prime limiting factor on slug velocity.
So what's the kind of recoil that would happen if you have a paint chip hitting something like a nuclear weapon? Would you in effect have two nuclear explosions? The hull. Pilgrimage. So somebody looking at the hull, we learn about pilgrimage. When quarians of the migrant fleet reach young adulthood, they must leave their birth ship and find a new crew to accept them as permanent residents. To prove themselves, they must recover something of value. This is offered to their prospective captain as proof that they will not be a mere burden on the shoestring resources of the ship. This process is called the pilgrimage. Stripped of ritual, the pilgrimage is merely an attempt to maintain genetic diversity within the small, relatively isolated population bases that make up the migrant fleet. If the young stayed and married within their birth vessel, the risk of inbreeding would increase sharply. Quarians are surgically fitted with their various immunity-boosting implants in preparation for leaving on pilgrimage. Having grown up within the sterile, controlled environments on the migrant ships, Quarians have virtually no natural immune system. Ablative armor. Excuse me. A warship's kinetic barriers reduce the damage from solid objects, but can do nothing to block guardian lasers, particle beams, and other forms of directed energy weapon. Do. The inner layer of warship protection consists of ablative armor plate designed to boil away when heated. The vaporized armor material scatters a dew beam, rendering it ineffectual. A scaffold is built around the interior pressure hull, with sheets of ablative armor hung from the structure. Ships typically have multiple layers of armor separated by empty baffles, spaces often used for cargo storage. Cruisers, which lack the internal space to fit dedicated fighter hangars, store the shipboard fighter complement in the baffles. It's not unknown for enlisted crew to build illicit alcohol distilleries in some obscure corner of the baffles, safe from prying eyes. Excuse me. Oh!
Normandy is amazing, Shepard. It's an honor to be among her crew.
I don't remember getting this one. But I guess I did. Okay. I think we were supposed to report somewhere for training. Spectre training. So we're going to do that next episode, and this is a long one. Tune back next time for that, and if not, we're just getting on the Normandy and leaving for one of the three destinations. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.